Welcome to Cycling Vancouver. My name is Steve. I'm a 58-year-old guy, 6'5", around 250 pounds, who enjoys violent combat sports, particularly hockey, football, and MMA, as well as lots of baked goods and cycling around the city. If you're interested in seeing what Vancouver looks like from the back of a road bike ridden by some spandex-wearing old dude, sit back and relax. This is Ride 251. Today is Saturday, June 3rd, 2023. It's a beautiful 22 Celsius sunny afternoon, and I'm heading out to ride into danger. On nice summer weekends like this, I want to get out of downtown and away from the crowds to where it is much safer to ride, but today I'm going to head north to the Burrard Inlet seawall and then west towards Stanley Park. I expect to encounter large crowds of casual riders at this time of day, something I normally try hard to avoid. Here is my Strava route map for this ride. They never look. Thank you. As Robert Frostbund wrote, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that made all the difference. The other road in this case leads to Vancouver's most popular cycling route, the Stanley Park Seawall, a flat 6 kilometer ride around the park's watery boundary. It's a lovely route, one that I last rode in April 2020, just before the seawall was closed to cyclists due to the city's heavy-handed response to COVID. If you're interested, check out my video for Ride 15 to see what a ghost town Vancouver was like back then. It was quite eerie. I'm gonna take the other road to Beach Avenue and head east away from the madness. The seawall ride is very popular with tourists and casual riders, and if you wanna ride it, I suggest you go early in the morning. I'm not sure what's going on here, but I suspect it has something to do with dragon boats. Now things will settle down and I can enjoy the ride. There are times when I'm suffering like now that I hate people riding e-bikes. I'm not sure what's up with this driver. I don't know whether they're drunk or just oblivious. Either way, I'm happy to get past and away from them. I got to Dunbar Street and decided I'd had enough, so I turned north back towards downtown Vancouver. While this was a nice ride, I managed to get in 44 kilometers and 423 meters of climbing. I have the Okanagan Grand Fondo coming up in a few weeks, so I think I'm going to have to make these rides longer and harder.